Thank you, Mr. Chairman, and thank both of you for being here. And you're both way too young to read an obituary, so I'm grateful that you retired at a young enough age to continue serving in new capacities. It's great to have both of you here, and it's a special honor to introduce Senator Conrad. I was telling him as we came in, the last time I introduced him, I was the tourism director. He was a senator, and I introduced him to be the keynote speaker at the grand opening of a tourism information center in Washburn, North Dakota, the Lewis and Clark Center. So it's been a long time. Lucy was very concerned then too, Senator. But it's great to have you here, and really couldn't hear from two better people. Senator Conrad is from Bismarck, where my wife and I live now, and after graduating, went to Stanford, where he received his bachelor's degree, and then received an MBA at George Washington University, and then went back home with a heart of service, and went to work in the tax commissioner's office, where Commissioner Byron Dorgan saw potential, evidently, and he worked for Commissioner Dorgan, who eventually became his colleague in the United States Senate. Senator Conrad does have a distinction in that he, both Senator Hoeven and I, are in the lineage of the Conrad seat. He held both U.S. Senate seats from North Dakota, not at the same time, of course, but I consider it an honor. During his 20 years, Kent was well known for being concerned about the budget, and lived it out every day in this place. Lived it out at home, always with North Dakota at the forefront of his concern and consideration. But was the real budget hawk that a lot of people turned to from both parties, and we're grateful for that legacy, Senator, and it's why, of course, you're here. So with that, I'm not going to go through all the incredible things he's done. He's going to give some great testimony I've already read. Thank you for that, and thanks for being here, and for your service to our state for all those years.